In this video, we'll see how to create a defect. By creating a defect, we'll be proceeding further for HP ALM workflow. What I mean by that, earlier we were working on test execution, but now after creating a defect, we can come to this phase that is nothing but defect tracking. Creating defect can be done by various methods. You can create a defect from your requirements, test cases, test sets, and also from the defects module. But in this video, I'll be showing you how to create a defect from the defects module. So let us see that practically.
Let us see how do we create a defect. There are various methods to create a defect. Let us see the first method. The easiest method is you can go to this defects module. And when you click on this place, you can see that's a user interface for this defects module. It works in only the grid view. There's no other tree view or something. It only works in the grid view. Now, if you observe, there are three defects which I've already created few minutes back. These are 1, 2 and 3. These are the defect IDs and some descriptions and all I've created. How do I create a new defect? First method is you can either click on new defect button, go to menu bars, or you can select this option as new defect, one and the same, or else you can use the shortcut key Alt N. So right now I'll just click on this new defect and it will get me a dialog box. This dialog box will ask me few details, like for example summary, detected by, severity and detected on date. The fields which are marked in the red color are mandatory. Here I can enter some defect name, let's say for example summary, login defect, like this, or some description I can enter on entering valid username and password and clicking on sign in button, flight finder page is not displayed. So I can mention like this any description here. Now along with the descriptions, if you see here, that's detected by the author name. Severity, it's given as urgent by default. If you want, you can change it anything. Assigned to, I can select some person name. Let's say I want to assign to Mercy. And similarly, there are a few more areas which we have. These are the different fields which are present here. The very most important field is status. When you if you're a manual tester, you might be aware about the defect lifecycle or bug lifecycle. Bug lifecycle is nothing but, you know, the status changes from new to the closed. You know, the time defect has been discovered till the time defect has been closed. So when you find the defect for the first time, the status would be as given as new. With every changes, the status will keep on changing here. I can give the defect priority as urgent because it's a defect related to login, and severity I'll give as high. That's the urgent place itself. And then I can simply click on submit. Now when I click on submit, if you observe, again this window will change it to a new defect, and if you see, all the fields have been cleared and I'll be getting a new dialog box here. I'll just click on this close button, and if you observe, a new defect is created and the name of the, or you can say the defect ID is number 4. Description is given the same what I've written here. On entering valid username and password and clicking on sign in button, flight finder page is not displayed here. Same way, this is the entire details about this particular defect. So this is the easiest method by which you can create, but there are various methods to create the defect, either from the requirements or either from the test plan or the test lab, and then we can also link this defect to particular test case or the requirements. When you create a defect, at the bottom if you observe, there's a description. If you want, you can add some comments in this place. You can also work on the attachments, linked entities, development activity and history. This all the areas are already aware since we have worked with this defects or the attachments, linked entities earlier also, right? So I hope you're able to understand how to create a simple defect by adding all the details. That's all for this video.